What's up, everybody? And I hope all of you are having a wonderful day today. As you can tell by what's in front of me and the thumbnail, I am opening up Yu-Gi-Oh! Ghosts from the Past. For those of you new to my channel, I upload videos 3 times a week, Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays at 12 p.m. Pacific time. I had to think for a second. So let's open this up. Get this open. And I will show off some of this. So I'm going to be opening up all of this. All 5 of these, because there's only 3 packs of cards in each one of these. So I am going to take a moment, pause my recording, make a cut, so I can get all of these open to make it easier, because I'm sure you don't want to see me open up all of these one by one. All right, and I'm back. I know it's going to seem very awkward as I cut the recording there for a second. So I just wanted to show off this. This is what the packaging looks like after it's open. So there is 3 packs per box. Five boxes per display. So that should be 15 packs total. And there are 5 cards per pack. If you don't know much about this, there are 5 Ghost Rares in Ghosts from the Past in this set. The most sought after one is the Dark Magician, this artwork specifically. The second best is the Blue Eyes Alternative White Dragon. And you've got the Blackluster Soldier coming in at 3rd. Crystal Wing Synchro Dragon at 4. And Firewall Dragon at number 5. So let's get into this. Madolche, Fresh, Sistart, Gear Town, Metal Foes, Volflame, Hieratic, Seal of Supremacy. And we got the Dragoonity Armagram. These are all ultra rares. So I am being as gentle as possible because there's only 5 cards per pack, which makes it very flimsy to open up these packs. We got the Hieratic Dragon of Tefnuit. The Hieratic Sun Dragon Overlord of Heliopolis. Sunvine Healer. And Time Thief Flyback. And the Starry Knight Flamel or Flamel. Yu-Gi-Oh! Card artwork is by far some of my favorite artwork on cards ever. They are nice artworks indeed. Not sure what else to say. I personally would like to pull the Ghost Rare Dark Magician, but my chances, I mean, the chances overall are the same as everybody else's, but I've only got a total of 4 of these boxes. And supposedly the pull rates are 1 per case. Some you can potentially get 2 per case, but that's for a case of these display boxes. And I did not buy a case. Starry Knight, Estelle. Sunvine Maiden. Metal Foes Fusion. Mask Change. And a Lovel Archer. I'm going to save that Dark Magician artwork. I think I want to save all the Dark Magician artworks for last. And I am trying to save the at least the fronts of these packs. Because I want to keep one of each pack art for myself. I like collecting the pack arts as well as the cards. Though I don't want to keep them sealed. I want to open them. Sunvine Healer. Time Thief Flyback. Hyo Zanryu. Cosmojo. Lavalval Salamander. So how has everybody been? Hopefully you have been hyped for this set as much as I have. I'm not sure what the next Yu-Gi-Oh! Set entails, as I don't keep up with what's coming out. I keep up a little bit, but not all the time. Sunseed Genius Loki. That's how I'm going to read that. I don't know if that's how it's pronounced. Galaxy Eyes Cypher Blade Dragon. Metal Foes Mithrilium. Artifact Durandal. Hieratic Seal of the Heavenly Spheres. That is the last one in that pack. And I opened the Dark Magician even though I said I was going to try and keep all those artworks for last. What would you like to see me open up in the future? Let me know down in the comments below. I will have a booster box of the Final Fantasy TCG coming soon. I might buy some more ghosts from the past so I can ghost rare hunt a little bit. And I will have some more Shining Fates and possibly Battle Styles. Also maybe looking into getting the Magic the Gathering. One of the new sets that's either already came out or it's coming out soon. Starry Night Blast. Hieratic Dragon King of Atom. Time Thief Redoer. Danger Thunderbird. Red Supernova Dragon. We'll set this one off to the side. This is the Firewall Dragon artwork. Firewall Dragon is roughly going for $190. That is the lowest or least expensive ghost rare in the set. Dark Magician is the top. Currently roughly priced at $635. Metal Foes Fusion. Dragon Knight. Draco Equist. Time Thief Perpetua. Hieratic Seal of Supremacy. Helshadal Hollow. That artwork is really neat. Kind of looks like a Like a flame armor. Blackluster Soldier on this artwork. That one is priced at about $320. The Blue Eyes Alternative White Dragon is roughly priced at about $340. And the Crystal Wing Synchro Dragon is about $275. That's just currently the list that I have and I'm looking at right now. Could possibly find it for less or for more. The Monarchs Erupt. Sun Avalon Dryas. Xyz Burst. Update Jammer. Dragoonity Knight. Aridbear. Now, if you feel that I am pronouncing any of these names wrong, I apologize. Yu-Gi-Oh card names are very hard to pronounce, and I am trying my best. Galaxy Eyes Cypher Blade Dragon. Splash Mage. Metal Foes Silvered. Sun Seed Shadow. Orchestrated Return is the last one in that pack. So we're going to go with the last Blackluster Soldier artwork, and then we will jump into all of the Dark Magicians, because I wanted to save those for last for some reason. Not like I think there's anything good, or I'm going to pull a Dark Magician out of a Dark Magician pack. That would be pretty dope, though. Metal Foes Mithrilium. Metal Foes Combination. Ojama Country. Madolche Fresh Sistart. Dragoonity Remus. That is the last card in this pack. So now we are hopping into the ghosts. The Ghost from the Past. We've been opening Ghosts from the Past since the beginning of this video. The Dark Magician artworks. Let's see if we get anything good. I would love to get a Ghost Rare, but do I expect to get a Ghost Rare? I do not. The pull rates are pretty hard. Dragoonity Draft. Dragoonity Hieratic Dragon of Tefnut. Time Thief Regulator. Photon Thrasher. Starry Night Balefire. Let's see. Four more packs remaining. Let's see if we can get anything good. I don't think I have pulled the... Well, I did. The Dragoonity Remus that I just pulled is the most valuable card that is not a Ghost Rare. Hyozanryu. Cosmol Dark Lady. I actually like that artwork. Looks like a witch with a lightsaber. Too bad it's got some scratches on it. Possibly print line-esque. Salvage. Time Thief Bezel Ship. And a Galaxy Eyes Cypher X Dragon. It's Let's hop into this next pack. I watched a couple of people's videos. Saw them pull some ghost rares. But one of the ghost rares I've seen, the quality was actually really good, so that's a good sign. Mask Change 2. Dark Requiem, Xyz Dragon. Cosmo Tin Can. Time Thief Hack. And another red Supernova Dragon. And I know I've said it in one of my past videos, but I want to reiterate, I am looking into doing giveaways, maybe cards that I pull, maybe some sealed product, but I definitely want to wait until I get more subscribers. I think my current subscriber count is a little low to start doing giveaways, even if I think giveaways might bring in more subscribers. Metal Foes Counter. Miracle Synchro Fusion. Madolche Chateau. Salaman Great Falco. And we got the Sun Avalon Drya Trentier. If any of you can pronounce that better than I just did, I commend you. Because that was hard to look at and try and say. And we are now on the last pack of today's video. Let's hope we can get some last pack magic with this. We have a Metal Foes Volflame to start off this pack. We have the Hieratic Seal of Supremacy. Hieratic Dragon of Tefnuit. The Hieratic Sun Dragon. And the last card of today's video is a Helshadal Hollow. No ghost rare for today, but that's okay. Not too much to go over as far as a recap goes. Let me just check one thing real quick. So the red Supernova Dragon and the Dragoonity Remus are the, I would say those are the top two pulls of today's video. As those are basically the two most, I mean, I'm going by price, as that's the best way that I can actually go off of as far as doing what is sought after or looking at what is sought after from players or collectors. Players want good cards, and good cards are usually priced highly. That is usually how it goes. We'll set these off to the side. And we have two red supernova dragons and a Dragoonity Remus. The Remus is about $17, $17, $18. And the red supernova dragons are about $7 each. So, not too bad. But with that, that's going to be the end of today's video. I want to let all of you know that I appreciate every single one of you for watching. And thank you so much for watching. But I will see all of you in the next video. Later.